From Phoebus High School, WHCS Channel 5 presents Missoula District Girls Basketball. The Kickatan Warriors visiting the Phoebus Phantoms. Good evening, everybody. I'm Tim Cole, along with Bob Hintz. We welcome you to Phoebus High School Gymnasium for the game between the undefeated Phoebus Phantoms and the 5-6 Kickatan Warriors. Right now, let's go quickly to Bob Hintz, who has head coach Anita Cooper of Kickatan High School.
Thank you, Tim. I got Anita Cooper here. Anita, being a first-year coach, you really jumped in. I know you first run your first game. How's the season gone so far?
It's going pretty well. I'm adjusting to a season of basketball, which is new to me, and they're adjusting to me well. And we're working hard, and I think we're doing all right now.
I know you got a transfer student in. Tell me a little bit about her.
Yeah, I got one from Florida, and she's stepped in, and she's on the starting team. She's putting forth a good, great effort for us, and I'm looking forward, you know, for the future for her.
What's her name?
Tashonda Henry.
She's number 10, so we'll see her tonight.
Yes, sir.
Well, when you play a team like Phoebus, and this is not the first time you played them, right, you've got to expect a lot of pressure.
Right, a lot of pressure, and they know that, and I just told them to go out and give it all they have and just try to knock Phoebus down. If we don't, then we just give it a good try.
Very good. Well, good luck to you tonight.
Yeah, thank you.
Very good. Tim, let's go back to you.
All right, thank you. Thank you, Anita, and we appreciate your taking a moment to talk with us, and we wish you the best. Speaking of the best, right now they're going to be taking on the best as Bob Hintz has Mike Talon, the head coach of the Phoebus Phantoms.
Thank you, Tim. Mike, just before you talk to your team, tell me a little bit about going this season so far.
We're real pleased with our overall defensive play, and offensively we think we're getting a little bit better now. So right now we're pretty happy.
Well, I see Kickatan's got a new gal, a 6'2 transfer student from Florida.
She looks like she's 6'4. But, It's great when you got more talent coming in the area. It just makes things more interesting.
Well, good. Good luck to you tonight, and we'll look forward to talking to you after the game if we get a chance. Okay, Mike. Tim, let's go back up to you.
All right, thank you. Thank you, Bob. And again, our most hearty congratulations to Mike Talon on the success of the Lady Phantoms so far this season. They are 11-0 in Peninsula District and 14-0 overall. And as usual, Mike has assembled a very fine group of young ladies who have done superbly well, led by, of course, All-American Lakeisha Frett, who just as a sophomore right now is averaging more than 22 points per game. So she is a very solid part of this team, but it's not a one-person team. The Lady Phantoms have done very well developing other players as well around this young lady.
Well, they sure have, Tim, but one thing that Mike has talked about all year since I have talked to him is how well the team plays together defensively, and that really makes them a very strong contender to go all the way this year.
All right, let's, if we can, pick up the starting lineups for these two teams. The visiting Kickatan Warriors will introduce, first of all, the new player you spoke of, Tashonda Henry, number 10. Number 13 is Vicky Pardue. Just ran out of your picture there. There you see Shavanka Lewis, who had a very good game against Hampton last Friday night, a game we had the pleasure of doing.
Yes, she was the player of the game.
Keisha Grant, number 25, also had a good game against Hampton, and she is a very aggressive ball player. And Tasha Abraham, one of the Abraham family, who have made their presence very well known on the peninsula. Abraham is having a very good season so far for the Kickatan Warriors.
So they call her TJ, so I think that'd be easier to say.
TJ?
Yeah, we'll just call her TJ.
I can work with that. And now we'll pick up the starters for Phoebus. They introduce first Janelle Hargrove, number 15, with a radiant smile. Kenya Vaughn, number 21, comes over to shake hands with head coach Anita Cooper of Kickatan. Third player introduced is 33, Keisha Reese. Lakeisha Frett, the All-American candidate, number 41, just a sophomore, and she is a great one. And the last introduction, Shavanka Chapman, number 42. Big smiles on these Phoebus girls' faces, as well they should. They've got a lot of things to smile about. They have played great basketball, and I know that Mike does not like to compare teams. Certainly he's had good teams that he could have compared with, but he kind of indicated that this team he didn't think was quite as strong as good as some of the teams he's had in the past. But boy, they might just be surprising both of us as we
see the officials. Tim Ratliff is walking toward you with the glasses, and the young man with the ball is Don Willis. And you talk about dating myself. Don played basketball and ran track and football for me over at Buckrow Junior High back when you were just a child, Tim.
All right, we have taken care of all of the pregame ceremonies and we are set to go. The only tip of the ball game is controlled by the Phoebus Phantoms. Inside it goes, Chapman banks it in.
And see, they go right inside quick. They're gonna put pressure on the middle of the Kickatan to try to find out how good this young lady is, this Henry.
And that trapping defense creates the turnover. The Phantoms quickly score two baskets. This is Keisha Reese. That man-to-man full court defense and a foul on Lakeisha Frett. Reaching over the back. And that'll be the first team foul. That will be a player control foul. 4 8-minute quarters in high school basketball. Most of the rules are the same otherwise. After five team fouls against a team, the opponent will shoot the 1-1. This is Vicky Pardue as she tries to break that press, gets the ball to Tashandra Henry on the baseline for Lewis. She is guarded closely and now a jump ball as she was guarded closely for 5 seconds without either shooting or passing.
Well, that was Javaga Chapman that was in there, Tim. She actually got a hold of the ball also, but you will see a lot of pressure from this Phoebus team. They want to make the other teams play the full court, not just half court. They're not going to let you walk the ball up very often.
Kickatan looking for their first points. They get it into TJ, and her shot won't go. And the rebound for Keisha Reese. Give it to Frett. Baseline jumper doesn't go. And TJ Abram has the rebound. Check that, that was Henry rather. She's almost as tall, the two of them are very tall. Henry, the more slender of the two. She looks like a basketball player.
Well, that was Mike's, when I talked to her, I said she's pretty big. He says, I said 6'2", he says she looks 6'4 to me. Because she does, she looks real tall.
And we should have a blocking foul on Vicky Pardue, that is the call. So Pardue, in an effort to defend the play, was still moving, did not have her feet set, and therefore very appropriately was called for the blocking foul.
And just importantly, it was called before she shot, so there will be no shot taken.
Inbounds pass comes to Chapman. She gets the roll. Siobhanka Chapman with two baskets, and it's 6-0 with 6:23 remaining here in the first quarter, and that pressing defense creates the turnover. Chapman in turn almost turns it over. And a traveling call.
Well, the reason he was traveling, she was on her knees when she got the ball, and she stood up without. If you're going to stand up, you got to come up dribbling. And she didn't do that. That's why the travel. Now, Mike's got him in a 1-2-2 full court trapping press.
And the turnover. Frett hit it.
And she's got such a pretty shot. I tell you, the kids that are watching this program, the watch how she releases the ball and how she keeps her eye on the basket. She is so good.
And yet another turnover. We don't have a statistician to keep turnovers for us, but
well,
almost any time
that was five
plays.
Right there, Tim.
And the conversion by Janelle Hargrove. So it's 10-0, Phoebus doing what they do so well. They play good defense, they cause the turnover, and then they get the easy basket. Go ahead, Bob, do a little spiel there for us.
Okay, well, we're going to talk about the two people that are helping us with the player of the game. We're going to pick a player of the game from each one of these teams, and we'll award a plaque to the player that will be donated by DC Engraving, and this is a sample of metal photo. DC Engraving is located in York Village Shopping Center on Route 17 in Grafton, and Dave Buckwalder, my good friend out there, doing a great job, and he received a letter from Mike Tallon. He says, first time anybody's acknowledged it. And I said, well, Mike Tallon's a class act. That's the reason you got the letter from. And we'll also be giving a shirt to the player of the game. And this is donated by Turner's Hardware and Sports Place, which is located in Willow Oak Shopping Center.
This is a replay, by the way. We were watching a little replay. I didn't want the fans to think they were missing the game. I'm sorry.
That's all right. And at two other locations. One's in Denby Hardware and Sporting Good in Denby Square, and the other one's a Sports Place located in the shops at Hampton Harbor at Hampton University. Dave Chubb and Bruce Hatch are the two people we want to talk about. And also that the Turners are the ones that are doing the shirt for the Promoco, this half a marathon that we'll be covering on the 10th of February.
All right, back to the live action. You may have seen Pardue called for the travel, and then Frett on the rebound ties up Abraham. And the ball with the possession arrow will belong to the Lady Phantoms. Some of the Kecoughtan cheerleaders on hand for this game. Literally neighborhood rivalries here in Kecoughtan and Phoebus. And the Phantoms lose it out of bounds. This is Vicky Pardue. Just about to get called for 5 seconds. As
well, you don't have a 5 seconds in the backcourt. You got that 10-second violation. They got to get it over. But once they get into the forecourt, then you get your 5 seconds closely guarded on defense.
Ball knocked out of bounds. It will still belong to the Warriors. 5:11 remaining in the first period. And it's 10-0 in favor of the Phantoms.
You can see what the Phantoms are trying to do. They're trying to harass the ball players to the point that it's hard for them to run their half-court offense because you get into a pattern, and they're trying to keep them out of that, and the pressure seems to be doing that right now. They picked up their second foul that's been whistled. Second or third foul has been whistled against the Phantoms.
That was Keisha Reese called for the personal foul. That is, in fact, the second team foul against Phoebus. Fret has the other, and this is Fret intercepting the pass. She'll go end to end and hit.
She pulls up and hits that 8 to 10 foot jumper as well as anybody I've seen, Tim.
High school or college, I don't care what ranking you're in. And there's Henry's first contribution on the part of the Kecoughtan Warriors, the young lady from Florida who just transferred to Kecoughtan. And Phoebus retaliates, Keisha Reese.
Oh, that was a nice feed from Fret. Fret came down the middle and just a little bounce pass. And nice, easy basket.
I'll tell you, one of the toughest things to do, Bob, is not to get into a let's talk about LaKeisha Fret. You want to say so many things about this young lady. I'm not her agent. I'm not her cheerleader. But, boy, she does so many good things. She dribbles. She passes. She shoots. She rebounds.
She knows what's going on in the floor, which really makes it nice. She's aware of other position of the players. She can dribble the ball with her head up. She looks for right there. Look at that pass. I mean, that was a great pass from half court to somebody wide open underneath the basket. And because of that, her teammates get a lot of points. So, you know, she scores a lot, but she also really compliments the rest of the team.
She averages more than 22 points a game and doesn't play two-thirds of most of the games because her team gets so far ahead. Mike Talon, very wisely so, gives the rest of the team a chance to get experience.
Well, a lot of the people will complain because Mike will leave his starters in or let them play a lot. And, you know, I have to go along with Mike doing this because, number one, they've got to maintain a certain amount of endurance by playing, and you keep your skills honed by playing, so you can't just because you're winning and by a big margin, you got to still play your players so they get the time in.
Sure, because there's a lot of very tough competition that awaits this Phoebus team should they advance beyond the peninsula play, postseason play, etc. We've got a foul underneath. This will be a two-shot foul. Let's see who this was called against for Kecoughtan.
Oh, that's on TJ Abraham. I thought she got a good block. She probably got her with the body.
And that was in the act of shooting, so we will see two free throws forthcoming. Here's your replay. Maybe you can see Abraham looked like she might have.
No, this is where it is. It's a fake, right? And
she did.
She got him with the body. And that's where it was a nice fake. Nice fake by number 42, Shivanka Chapman.
Chapman has 5 points with that free throw. Our first charity stripe event of the evening, and she's got good form for both of the free throws. 18-2 in favor of Phoebus, and Fret intercepts, puts it up, can't get it to fall. And back come the Warriors. Underneath for Henry, a little too hot, as that pass had some good mustard on it, and she just couldn't hold on to it.
Well, number 23, Shivanka Lewis, they like to call her Joby. Joby threw the ball rather hard, but she was open about two seconds before that. Had she looked down court, she could have got the ball to her much easier. But again, that's hindsight. I can sit here and look and see all this thing happening.
Isn't that something? Isn't that the truth? Look at here. Fret picks the ball out of the air. Spots a teammate underneath, decides instead to shoot, and misses. Back come the Warriors. Pace is quickening here. Off the glass, no good. Good follow-up by Lewis. We saw her hustle extremely well against Hampton the other night. She's a good ball player, and she misses again, however. Back come the Phantoms. Fret looking inside, spots a teammate on the baseline. Quickly, good defense by Kigatan as they get down there quickly, and then Mickey Pardue ties up.
Yes, that was excellent defense on the Warriors. They had to hustle to get down there. It looked like there was going to be a breakaway shot for the Phantoms, but they didn't get it.
And Phoebus, or rather Kigatan, will have possession on the possession arrow. 18-2 with 2.5 minutes remaining in the first period. And we'll get another foul. This will be one of overly aggressive defense by Keisha Reese. That's her second. Second time she has gone for the ball and missed the ball and gotten the player. And Keisha will come out in favor of number 21, Kenya Vaughn. So it's Fret, Chapman, Vaughn, Hargrove, and Felicia Bishop, who is in the ball game now. And we've got another violation.
Well, he called a 5-second violation. It was either that or a 3-second count. I wasn't sure what he was going to call. Kigatan is picking him up full court, putting pressure on him now.
You don't see that very often against Phoebus. They've got such good inside shooters that they'll burn you if you're not careful. Fret follows and gets the roll. So Fret with 6 points in the first period. We have a minute 57 remaining, and the Phantoms lead 20-2. And a travel call against Mickey Pardue. I didn't really see it.
Well, she picked her foot up before she dribbled. Felicia Bishop, number 12, is putting a lot of pressure on her. And what she's got to do is get that ball up court, not looking to pass, but to dribble at.
And a shot and a foul. This foul will be charged against Keisha Grant, number 25, as she got too close to Fret on the jumper. And Fret will get 2 shots. 1:49 remaining in the first period. Tim Cole with Bob Hintz. This game recorded on the 29th of January, 1991. Coming to you from Phoebus High School. The undefeated Phoebus Phantoms, 11-0 in the district and 14-0 overall. Playing against the 5-6 Kigatan Warriors under first year coach, Anita Cooper. Fret gets the first of two. And she's perfect as the Phantoms are 4-for-4 from the charity stripe. And they lead by 20. Here's the replay a little earlier.
You can see that foul. She really blocked her out well, but she took her feet out from under the place where she was able to come down.
Is that some slow-mo Joe action
there? I don't know who's doing it, but that's excellent.
Fret got it. Oh, she's got such a pretty shot. Slow-mo Joe is back.
All right.
I don't think he ever left. 10 points, very quiet 10 points, and we've got a hurt player back. Janelle Hargrove has been.
She ran into a great screen, and this was not a malicious thing, but TJ Abraham sent a screen that was just unbelievable, and she may have run into her elbow or something. But there was not an illegal screen or anything. That was a good screen. I don't know if we've got it or not, but wow.
I saw her go down as she got clobbered, but as you said, it was certainly nothing dirty or illegal about it. It just simply was one of those good, solid picks.
We see
it right here as Abraham.
She ran into her elbow, Tim. Yeah. If you can see her head hit her elbow, but that was an excellent pick. TJ was there 2 or 3 seconds before the young lady Janelle Hargrove ran into her, and you can watch it as she's coming up in the top left of your screen. Yeah. Boom, right there. And it was nothing. Well, see, in that case is what Fret should have done. Acacia Fret should have said, screen, let Hargrove know that there was a screen there so she could come around the screen, and there just wasn't the communication that there should have been.
Mike Tallon.
Well, she's moving her knee like she may have hurt her knee when she went down, so that could be a big thing. This young lady has been a starter, has been a kind of a spark plug. She's got a lot of energy and brings a lot of excitement to this team. And, of course, number 12, Felicia Bishop, comes in and does a great job, but you hate to lose a start, especially when you're getting ready to finish up the season, go into the the tournament, Mike.
Well, it looks like Hargrove has that right knee pretty heavily bandaged anyway, and it's a distinct possibility that she may have re-injured that knee, although it appeared that the brunt of the hit had taken place, as you said, when she ran into her and might have hit her head, but she's definitely flexing her right knee, so she is in definitely some pain, and Mike is saying, come on, come on, here, let's
well, she's got a little smile on her face, so I think she's shaking her head like it's maybe not be too bad, but I'm sure Mike will get over to the side and get the ice on her knee.
And, of course, I'm sure that he's telling her right now, don't hurry. Take your time. If you want to try and get up, fine. If not, you know, sit there as long as you need. A minute 13 remaining here in the first period. We're going to watch that one more time. We're going to show you, watch and see if we can see what happens to her knee. Here she comes. There you see to the left-hand side of your screen, Abraham, it looks like she definitely ran into Abraham's knee with her knee.
That may be what it is. I thought at first with her elbow on her head, I thought maybe that's what the injury was, but it's she just clanked knees with her.
So we've had a prolonged stoppage in play here while Janelle Hargrove is attended to.
And while we got this, why don't you talk a little bit about the Hampton Marathon? The Pamoco Run.
The Hampton Half Marathon, which is coming up on the 10th of February. That will be sponsored by the Pamoco Group, and it's being held in the city of Hampton, of course, on the 10th of February. It's a 13.1-mile race. And we understand that Slow-Mo Joe has been practicing.
Hey, they don't call him Slow-Mo when he gets on the track.
That's right. I heard he's been running.
He goes fast motion.
Running 6-7 blocks a day, so by the time that thing is ready to roll, he should be ready for it. But we'll be there to cover that here on Channel 5, and all of those of you that plan to go out there, we hope you'll enjoy yourselves and just hope we have good weather. 10th of February is kind of a precarious time of the year around here to have a outdoor running event.
Well, it could be in the 60s or it could be in the 20s.
You're absolutely right, but we'll see how it works out. We'll be there. Hope you come on out for that half marathon on the 10th of February in the city of Hampton. So we're back to the live action now, and we're happy to say that Ms. Hargrove was able to make her way to the sidelines, and hopefully she'll be able to return. Abraham underneath, TJ with her first basket of the night, and after a long drought, the Kickitan Warriors now have 4 points.
Well, that was a nice feed inside to her. And Kickitan is in a zone. They're trying to pack it in and keep the ball out from their big people inside, but it doesn't seem to be doing any good. There was a errant pass.
So Fret broke to the basket, and Chapman didn't realize she was going to and threw it over her head. So the turnover with 37 seconds remaining in the first. Back come the Lady Warriors. This is Lewis taking the ball back to Amy O'Brien, who has checked in for the Warriors. Shot by TJ doesn't go. Back comes Lakeisha Fret. And almost mishandled by her teammate. Jumper is no good, but O'Brien committed the foul. So number 32 for the Kickitan Warriors kind of jumped into the Phoebus player.
Well, you can see that the coaching is really excellent on this Kickitan team. They're blocking out.
Here's your replay.
You can see they're blocking out. They're just making the contact. You don't make that kind of contact. You know, a little contact you can get by with, but not that kind of contact.
And Kenya Vaughn hits the first. 6 seconds remaining in the first period. That's the first miss from the free throw line for the Phoebus team tonight. 1 second, as it would appear that Lewis did not realize there was no time, or little time at least, remaining. And You know, I don't want to that sounded critical. I don't want people to think I'm being critical. These are just young ladies playing high school ball for the first time, but she was not aware at the time. I was watching a game on ESPN last night, the Syracuse University of Connecticut game.
I've watched the end of that too.
5 seconds to go, the kid didn't shoot the ball.
Yeah, so you know, we talk about this, we're not. And here's you can see some of the replays. This is a nice feed. We'll be going inside, but anyway. We talk about not being aware of the clock and everything, and you see them in college not being aware of it. So we're not, like you said, we're not being critical. That was a nice feed from Pardue into TJ Abraham. But the good ball players like Fret and all seem to have a sense about them that they know without looking, they know how much time's left on the clock and just knows things that you can't teach. That you learn by playing the game of basketball.
The mental aspects of the game, no question. Second period just underway. It was 25-4 in favor of Phoebus as we start. Akeisha Fret can't get it to fall, but she draws the foul.
That was a nice move, and that was a very good, quick first step she made to go around Henry, number 10.
Foul is on TJ Abraham. That's her second. And that will be the bonus time, although Fret would be shooting two in any event. But from this point on, for the duration of the first half, here's your replay.
And you see how fast she went around Henry, and she was hit on the arm as she went up for the shot. There's a good shot of the brain trust, headed by, of course, Mike Talon.
Fret's second goes halfway down and comes back out. So she's 3-for-4 from the free throw line, and she has a total of 11 points here in the first half. Siobhanka Lewis, and a whistle away from the play. Looks like a 3-second violation, or at least a time violation of some sort.
Yeah, he just signaled the Phoebus ball, and I didn't catch the violation.
So the turnover gives the ball back to the Phantoms. Inside, heavy traffic, it's kicked back out.
This young lady is just got Mike Talon's real high on this young lady, just made that shot, number 21, Avon. She has got a nice shot. You can see she's just not as aggressive as he'd like her to be, but she's just a sophomore.
So she's got a sophomore, some nice young, and Fret's a sophomore, right?
Yes.
Look at this, she almost picked that ball up, did in fact loosen it up. Lakeisha will drive and miss the shot, but her follow-up goes.
Well, I think that Abraham did a good job of getting back down and put a little pressure on her and not fouling her.
Almost stolen by the Phantoms. Keisha Reese had a hand on it, but the Warriors retained possession. 30-4 as Phoebus continues their winning ways. Abraham. Shot is forced up by Grant, but she will draw the foul. Foul is on Lakeisha Fret. That'll be her second. And we'll have new players coming in now. Desiree Allen will come in and replace Keisha Reese for the Phantoms. And the young lady at the free throw line, Grant, will be coming out in a moment. Here's your replay.
Now this is where the foul is committed as she goes to the basket, drives into the basket, and she is fouled right there. She was attempting a shot.
Fret got her on the arm. Grant misses the first of two. This is the first visit to the free throw line for the Warriors. Grant misses on both. Back come the Phantoms. Fret has her pass picked off. And the Warriors turn it over the other way. That's two things that Fret's shown me tonight, that she actually is human.
She's human.
She's
not, yeah, that was not a good pass. She didn't concentrate on what she was doing, that she wouldn't have made that pass. But she's human. She's going to make mistakes.
I'm just teasing her. I hope she doesn't misunderstand me. I am such a fan of hers. Nice quick move, 13-footer, good. 15 points for Frett, and we still have 5:48 remaining in the half. Played a little more than 12 minutes, and she's got 15 points already.
Well, you notice Phoebus is not on their full court press anymore, but Kickitan is. They're trying to get some turnovers to get back in the ball game.
Lewis got a bucket. Frett brings it back and gets the roll. So Lakeisha is warming up.
She's got half of the team's points.
Baseline to Henry, who's trying to familiarize herself with the rest of the Kickitan Warriors, and a travel call. That could have been a foul on Frett. That would have been her third.
I'm not sure that that was a travel.
In any event, a little good break for Frett, because she would have been whistled for her third foul had it been.
Janelle Hargrave come back in, and that, I know that makes the Phantoms real happy that she is back in and did not make a very good pass there to the wrong teammate.
Shavanka Lewis scores her second bucket. As I mentioned before, Lewis, one of the better players on this Kickitan team, has been held rather quiet so far. Lakeisha Frett is not.
She handles that ball with both hands.
I'm going to let you do the raving here, because I don't want to make it sound like I'm her agent, but if she needs an agent, I'll be glad to talk to her. Abraham on the baseline got the bank shot. She has 4 points, and the Phantoms lead by 26. And then we have a foul as the ball was passed across the mid stripe. 32 is the foul on O'Brien. And Hargrove will come back out now, and replacing her will be Desiree Allen. And Nikki Perdue will replace Amy O'Brien in the lineup for the Warriors. Here's the replay. Watch Frett here. She's going to
right there. You can
tag
see
pretty good.
O'Brien grabbed her arm.
And Frett misses, but the rebound comes out to Chapman. Chapman has the ball partially blocked. Reese got the loose ball and then finally missed again.
Well, Reese turned around to shoot that ball and saw a 6'2 young lady with her arms up. And she had to alter her shot a little bit.
Stolen by Frett. Reese, and a whistle and a foul. Foul is going to be called against Shavanka Lewis. That'll be her first. Both teams are over the limit. 1-1 coming up for Keisha Reese. Doesn't get it, but good position underneath by Chapman. Her shot won't go, but she draws the foul from Henry.
If she did a head fake, she'd have got her up and maybe caught the foul and had a better shot at the basket, but she got the foul, and that was a good move that she did to get that rebound.
So Shavanka Chapman will go to the free throw line. She has 6 points. And all of a sudden, the Phantoms are cold from the free throw line, having missed their last five in a row after hitting their first six. Make that six. And we've got a foul in what might have been a jump ball, but in fact is ruled a foul.
Well, one of the officials called it a jump ball, but the other official, Mr. Rent, said, no, that's a foul on number 42.
That's Chapman whistle down. And the game has slowed considerably here in the second period with a proliferation of fouls from both teams.
Well, that'll make a game go a little bit longer, Tim, when you start having a lot of fouls called.
Nikki Perdue, she gets the bonus.
Not many teams have scored in the double figures against the Phantoms in the first half, especially with just half of the time going off of the in the second quarter.
Purdue missed, but Henry put the rebound back in for two, and it's 36-12. So the Warriors having a much better second period than they did the first. Back come the Warriors. Shivanka Lewis can't get it to go, but Abraham follows.
Well, that's five straight points by the Warriors.
In heavy traffic, the foul by Vicky Purdue. That'll be her second. And Janelle Hargrove will come back in for Phoebus, replacing Kenya Vaughn, and a timeout has been called. Here's some of the replay of that previous action, just the tail end of it, the foul on Purdue. There has been a timeout called by Anita Cooper over here. You see Anita and her Kingitan Warriors. 3:20 remaining in the first period, first half. 36-14 in favor of the Phoebus Phantoms. While I got a moment here, I'd like to make the fans aware of the current standings as of the present time, which is the 29th of January. And these are compliments of Mike Keach and the fine folks over the Daily Press who compiled these for us. We appreciate all of his efforts and the newspaper's efforts to provide us with these stats. Phoebus, of course, is undefeated and atop the Peninsula District standings. Gloucester, first year in the Peninsula District, is doing extremely well, 9-2 and 11-3 overall. Then Lafayette, 8-3. Menchville, 7-4. Denby, 6-5. Then a two-way tie with Ferguson and Kingitan at 5-6, and then Bethel and Warwick at 2-9, and then Hampton at 0-11 at the bottom of the heap in the standings of Peninsula District. But Phoebus on top, just ahead of the Gloucester girls. In and out as the cold free throw shooting continues, but Chapman gets the rebound and then can't get it to go.
I tell you, the shooters are intimidated by the height that the Kingitan Warriors have underneath the basket.
In it comes for Chapman. She has it blocked. Keisha Reese fakes, shoots, hit it.
Yeah, nice fake and right over the top of TJ Abraham.
38-15, 3 minutes remaining in the first half. You're watching the Kingitan Warriors and the Phoebus Phantoms, the girls game. And it's picked off by Frett. She has two teammates in front. She gives to Hargrove, who shoots a little too hard, but Reese follows and gets. Keisha Reese with 8 points in the first half. And it's 40-15. Lewis lobs it in for Abraham. She is double teamed. Spots Henry underneath for the easy basket.
And nice look and pass by TJ.
That'll be a nice added dimension to the Kingitan team, and they'll, of course, have basically the second half of the season to get the adjustments made.
Well, let's call the old high-low. One of the big players goes outside and looks underneath for one of the other ones, and that was a nice work of their offense on the half-court end.
On the other end, TJ Abraham will be called for her third personal foul, as she went over the back to get the rebound, a little too aggressively, too much contact. There you see the replay, and there you saw Abraham as she just got too much of Lakeisha Fred, who will go to the free throw line with the 1-1. Good camera work, people, as usual. Lakeisha. Twenty points here in the first half for Lakeisha Fred.
Well, you talk about a camera, people. We got Ron Baton on the sideline camera. Jerome Young is on one of the cameras, and I don't know who is on the other camera. Maybe the director will tell me. Melvin Hooker, he hooks as the guy, as the man said. Oh, Melvin, yeah, he's done some, did some ball games for us, some football games. He was on camera.
Nice look underneath for Hargrove, but she can't get it to fall. She gets her own rebound and gets fouled. So she's upset. She says, I should have had that one.
Of course, we don't want to forget Beverly Penn in the truck with Slow-Mo and Dr. Sam, and then Scotty is right behind us keeping everything straight.
He smacked me twice just in the first half for a long. Here's your replay. Hargrove left all alone, just couldn't get the layup, and then she got her follow shot, and she was fouled in the act by Grant. That one off the heel of the rim. I wore my Channel 5 shirt tonight, but you didn't. See, we haven't connected yet.
I know. When I wear,
we do have navy slacks on.
Yeah, when I wear my shirt, you don't. When I wear a sweater, you wear a coat. I wear a coat, you wear, I don't know. We got to get coordinated here.
We get some blazers from those fine folks over there at Turner's. Minute 30 remaining, 42-17. Or at least light jackets, right, Scotty?
Yeah, something.
With Channel 5's logo on it. Hargrove in heavy traffic has it knocked away. Chased down very quickly by Felicia Bishop. This is Vaughn's shot, a little short. And the ball is battled for, and the traveling would appear the two Phantoms were fighting over.
That's exactly what happened. Janelle Hargrove didn't know who was the other one that had to hold the ball, and she wasn't going to give it up, and it was her teammate. But that's hustle. You don't mind to see that if you're a coach and you like to see that kind of hustle. Nothing wrong with that. Okay. Oh, Joe Lewis is really picking. I guess he's mad because you talked about how much he runs, 7 blocks a day or something like up to 7, right? So he's going to pick on both of us now.
What did Joe say something about we get some real announcers, we get some real jackets?
Yeah.
Boy, that's the last nice thing I'll say about him. 25 seconds remaining in the first half. Inside, Hargrove has it knocked away. Vicki Pardue has kick it to hand, wants to run. Siobhanka Lewis, length of the court, put it up off balance, no good. And now the rebound from Chapman. 10 seconds left. Hargrove, baseline has it, guarded by the taller Henry. 2 seconds, and the shot is partially blocked at the buzzer. So at halftime, the Lady Phantoms lead 44-17. Over the Kingitan Warriors. We'll return to Phoebus High School for the third half of action. Second half, third quarter. See, I can't even talk now. It got me all upset. We'll be right back. Score at halftime, the Lady Phantoms, who led 25-4 after one period, and lead at halftime 44-17. And as usual, the Lady Phantoms were paced by Lakeisha Frett, who had 21 points, 16 from the floor and 5 out of 7 from the free throw line. 8 points for Keisha Reese, all of those coming from the floor. 6 points for Siobhanka Chapman, 2 baskets, and 2 of 5 from the free throw line. 5 points for Kenya Vaughn, 2 baskets, and 1 of 2 from the free throw line. And 4 points for Janelle Hargrove, who had 2 baskets and was 0 for 2 from the free throw line. For the Kingitan Warriors, Tashandra Henry, the newcomer to the lineup, had 6 points, all from the floor. 6 points also for TJ Abraham, and again, all of those from the floor. Siobhanka Chapman had 4 points, no free throws, and 1 point for Vicky Pardue. And Keisha Grant was the only other player who attempted a free throw. She was 0 for 2. So the Warriors were 1 for 4 from the free throw line in the first half. As we mentioned before, the Kigatan Warriors under head coach Anita Cooper, first-year coach Anita Cooper. And, of course, Mike Tallon, the head coach for the Phoebus Phantoms, and he has done such an outstanding job through the years. And he has another strong team this year, and two of his best players are just sophomores.
I know, and it's amazing. And Mike, a lot of people say, well, Mike's lucky, but I tell you that they – a lot of what he does and the success that the Phantoms have had over here, the Lady Phantoms, is because Mike Tallon is a great teacher. He teaches the fundamentals. He's very consistent with it. The team responds to him. And, you know, you can just see there's a genuine appreciation and love between the coach and the players.
From Nikki Reed to... heavens knows that a ton of them in the last few years.
We go back to Tammy Boggs and all kinds of young ladies that went through this system over here.
Kigatan will get the ball to start the second half. We're just underway. And the turnover as the Warriors throw it away. Coming into the second half, no players on Phoebus have more than 2 fouls. Fret and Reese have 2. And for Kigatan, Abraham has 3, while O'Brien and Grant each have 2, as well as Vicky Pardue.
Well, now we have another turnover by the Phantoms, which is very uncharacteristic of them bringing the ball up, but the Warriors have jumped out and they're continuing their full court pressure, trying to slow the Lady Phantoms down a little bit.
Grant and another turnover. So both teams come out playing very sloppy to start the second half.
Well, that was a real hard pass at such close quarters.
Fret double team gives off to Chapman. Reese is open. She'll step a little closer, shoot it. It won't go. And a tie up underneath as a good follow by Chapman. Ball will belong to Phoebus on the possession arrow. Or is that in fact the case? Yes.
Yeah, because Kigatan started off with the ball.
So we've got that ironed out as the two officials, Tim Ratliff and Don Willis, confer, and we're set to go as the Phantoms will inbounds under their basket. This is Kenya Vaughn, guarded by Vicky Pardue. And then Grant fouls Keisha Reese. That'll be 3 on Grant.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I like what Anita Cooper has brought to this team is she's brought them a sense of playing more aggressive defense. And that'll win you a lot of ball games. Maybe not against a team as good as this Phantom team, but definitely will get you a lot of wins that you may be outmanned, but just because of your aggressive defensive pressure.
Phoebus still retains possession. Vaughn will shoot from 14, no good. And back come the Warriors.
And that was a long rebound. LaKeisha Fret was breaking into the basket to rebound, and it bounced over her head.
Pass in for Abraham is picked off by Fret. Keisha hit from behind, doesn't get the call. And then we got a jump ball, and it'll belong to the Warriors.
You're right about that shot. LaKeisha Fret went up with a shot. She got a little push from behind, and the shot ended up being a little bit longer than what she had intended.
Just a little too tricky on the pass there.
And I know Mike Tallon doesn't like this sloppy play, and it makes him upset because he wants to see him play with a lot of composure, and it's not happening right now. They're not looking real smooth.
Desiree Allen has replaced Chapman in the lineup for Phoebus. This is Grant. She has it blocked. Hargrove spots Frett. Frett will bank it in.
Nice job by Hargrove getting the ball and then keeping her head up to see the open Frett breaking to the basket.
Shavanka Lewis. Lewis loves that running one-hander. Can't get it to go, but TJ Abraham follows with the stick back. Long pass down court, and it's a little too tall for Keisha Reese. And we'll get Shavanka Chapman coming back in the game. This time she'll replace Kenya Vaughn. We see Miss Chapman, number 42, and the Zebra, one of two.
Well, Don Willis has put a lot of weight on since he used to run 220 in the 100-yard. He might have a little problem with that.
TJ Abraham with two baskets in a row, and it's 46-21. 5.5 minutes remaining in the third. Stolen inside by Lewis. Nice feed back to Lewis. Lewis will put it up. Oh, a little too strong, and back come the Phantoms. Keisha Frett is loose. Put it up with the left hand. She got it, and she's fouled.
Well, by putting it up with the left hand, she kept her body between her and Henry, number 10, going up to make the block, and that's why she drew the foul.
She is not a natural left-hander, I don't believe.
No, she isn't.
Watch this. She will dribble with the left.
Nice pass. As you can see, this is our side camera, and you can see she's really concentrated. Got her head up and follows that ball right off the glass. Excellent camera work. Ron Baton down there on the sideline. Slow-mo Joe doing his good job. That was great camera work.
And Frett shows why she is considered one of the most outstanding young lady ball players in the nation. USA Today picked her as one of the most outstanding young players in the nation.
And they must have had a reason.
Well, the reason is rather obvious.
Yes.
Even I, who don't know that much about basketball.
You could pick that one up.
I could pick that one up.
Yeah. We just had a little communication from our director.
Slow-mo Joe is apologizing. I don't remember him apologizing to me.
Well, you're the one that said something about him running only seven blocks. You see, I know he runs more than seven blocks.
I meant at a time.
Oh.
Chapman, not much movement on the part of the Phantoms. Reese's shot won't go, and Kenya ties up Henry underneath. And the ball will belong to the Phantoms.
Well, Kenya is giving up about 6 inches, but she's a fighter for that ball.
4:45 remaining in the third, 49-21. And a shot and a foul as Desiree Allen will go to the free throw line. Foul will be the second on Shavanka Lewis, and LaKeisha Frett will come back in. Placing Chapman, here's your replay. Well, you saw them, here you go. This is Allen getting fouled emphatically.
She was fouled good.
Question.
I mean, there was no doubt about that
she
one.
Got it good. So Allen gets the first of two. And this was a little too strong. But the rebound comes off to Reese, and she cans it. The foul is called against Abraham. That's her fourth. And we'll get a chance to watch this one again. There you saw Abraham just got her as she released the ball.
Yeah, she did. If she'd have kept her hand up, there would not have been a foul, but she went down and followed through with her hand and hit her on the arm, and that's where the foul was. But I think we now have a foul on LaKeisha Frett. No, I'm sorry, number 21. On
Kenya Bond. So the fouls have been continuing.
And number 31, Dina Franklin. I talked to her mother tonight, and it is Dina.
Good.
And she says, I understand, and we didn't know. She said people call all kinds of things, but Dina is her name.
Well, we're glad to straighten that out. And that is Dina Franklin shooting and missing. Those of you that may have seen our coverage of the game the other night, we were undecided as to whether it was Deanna or Dina. So we
and that's a lot of people call her Deanna, but it is Dina. And I was hoping she would get in so we could get that straight.
Foul is number 4 on Keisha Grant. Here's your replay. There you see Fret.
You see how well Joe goes from one camera to another? I mean, that guy is just amazing.
What are you, buttering him up now?
Hey, I'm going to keep Joe on my good side. Now, you ain't want to. This guy, as many hot sausages as he made sure you had, boy, you ought to be talking nice things about Joe Lewis.
I am. That's my buddy Joe. My buddy Slow Mo Joe. In case you ever see anyone riding around in a big Chevy Blazer with the license plate Slow Mo Joe, that's him. That's the one. Checking into the lineup now is Valerie White. First time we've seen her this evening. She played rather extensively the other night against Hampton. Fret steals the inbounds pass. Short jumper is good. And she steals another pass.
Well, what Kickatan is doing wrong is they're moving the ball up the court, and then they're stopping the dribble, and they don't have any options. And the pressure that the Phantoms put on the other ball players, they're easy to pick off the passes.
Twenty-seven points in the ball game so far for Lakeisha Fret. Hargrove hits the first of two. Fret 56-21. There you see a good look at Janelle Hargrove. And she misses the second, but the rebound comes off to Reese, and two tries later, she cans it. Franklin has it stripped by Reese. Reese will bank it up, no good. Fret follows and hits. Boy, I'll tell you, they are just too much. You cannot give up for a moment.
Oh, I tell you, once they put that full court pressure on and denying the ball, and that's exactly what they're doing. They have nobody guarding the player bringing the ball in, Dina Franklin, and but nobody was open. She had nobody to throw the ball to, and it's a turnover.
60-21. If you're wondering, yes, the Phantoms have broken the 100-point mark previously this season. And a foul inside. This one is on Henry. That will be her third. So 3 on Henry, 4 on Abraham, and 4 on Grant, and 3 on Lewis. So the Warriors are in some foul trouble here. Keisha Reese, 1 of 4 from the free throw line. Make that 2 out of 5. Reese has 12, 14 points so far. Make that 15. And Nikki Pardue dribbles it off for leg. Shoot, can't get it to go. Vaughn, good position, no go. Second shot, no.
Well, finally, she was in the right position both times. The weak side rebounder just couldn't connect.
Finally, Henry was able to get the board for Kickitan. 62-21. Knocked away by Reese. Good anticipation. Reese will put it up and in. Shavanka Lewis can't get it. Got her own rebound. Good hustle by Lewis. That's what earned her player of the game on our call the other night for the Kickitan Warriors. Almost walked.
That may have been a walk. I think the officials weren't paying attention, but I believe that might have been a walk. If it wasn't, it was awful close.
Foul is on Dina Franklin. Chapman getting set to come back in for the Phantoms, and she will replace Desiree Allen. Here's your chance to see whether or not this is a walk. One, two, well, who knows? She let it go before that second foot came down, but close no call. Hargrove misses. Chapman underneath, got the rebound, couldn't get it to go in, and finally controlled by Hargrove. Into Chapman, her shot too strong. Fret had it for a moment, lost it, but the stick back is good by Kenya Vaughn. Good second and third and fourth opportunities for the Phantoms. I didn't see who made the shot.
Oh, that was Nikki Pardue made that shot. She went right down the center, and then we had another put up by number 33 for the, and that's Reese for the Phantoms. Keisha Reese is playing a great game out there tonight, too.
Well, we mentioned, and I wasn't trying to be just generous about this, but this is not a one-person team that Phoebus has on the floor. They have some good team players. We saw Fret with the rejection. Lewis can't get it tipped out for Hargrove. 50 seconds remaining. Left side feed, Fret got it.
Nice feed from Janelle Hargrove. Excellent look.
70-23, another Phoebus blowout. So far, there just isn't anyone in the Peninsula District who can stay with this team.
Well, Gloucester came the closest, and the night I saw them play Gloucester and Gloucester got beat by 6 points, Phoebus was real, real flat. I've not seen them that flat, so they are not infallible.
Two points unofficially for LaKeisha Fret here in the ball game, and she still hasn't played any of the fourth quarter. But a foul inside before the shot. That'll be number 4 on Henry. Chandra Henry with her fourth personal. Shavanka Chapman goes to the free throw line. With 10 seconds remaining in the third, here's your replay.
And it's just a nice pass inside. And Henry, just you can see her, she just reaches right over.
Chapman hit the first. She's got nothing but net. 72-23. 10 seconds to go. Third period. And we've got a foul on Hargrove with 3 seconds to go.
Did you see the excitement that Hargrove brings? I mean, she is diving on the floor, going after the ball. Hustle. Her middle name's got to be Hustle. Watch her. There she is going around to the other side. Right down for the ball. It's on the floor. Let's go get it. But she got a hold of the arm in the process.
This is a player control foul. The Phantoms put on good pressure. It's stolen, but before Kenya Vaughn can shoot it, the buzzer sounds, ending the third period.
Well, while we got a break at the action, let me do go one more time, talk about the player of the game. We're going to give a plaque to each player from each one of these team. A player of the game is donated by DC Engraving. It's a sample metal photo. DC Engraving is located in York Village Shopping Center on Route 17 in Grafton, and Dave Buckwalter is a young man you need to see out there. We're also going to give a shirt with Player of the Game on it. This is donated by Turner's Hardware and Sports Place, which is located in Willow Shopping Center. Turner's has two other locations to serve you, one at Denby Hardware and Sporting Goods, located at Denby Square, and the newest store, the Sports Place, located in the shops at Hampton Harbor next to Hampton University. Dave Chubb and Bruce Hatch are the two people you want to see. And we sure appreciate all the help that these fine folks give us.
Yes, we do. And we, you know, we appreciate the fact that Mike Tallon dropped a note to them to advise them and thank them for the shirt and the plaque for his player of the game. And we, you know, speaking of dropping a line, we'd love to hear from you fans if you have some comments about our games, if there's something you'd like us to do for you or do differently, or some ideas, comments, whether it be pro or con. We'd love to hear from you. Just drop a letter or a card to WHCS Channel 5, 1819 Nickerson Boulevard in Hampton. And we'd love to get a note from you, see what you think about our coverage. Kenya Vaughn hits. She's got 9 points on the night, 74-23. Warriors led, excuse me, the Phantoms led 10 to nothing and have never looked back. Lewis to Grant, and a 5-second violation. Didn't seem like she had the ball 5 seconds.
Didn't think so either.
There is no shot clock in high school ball. You do not have to shoot within a prescribed period of time. What a nice move by Fred. She saw the block being set up, and she just dribbled around it. King Yvonne hits her second in a row.
Okay, she's got a nice shot. She gets a little more aggressive and will look for her shot more often. That'll really make Mike Tallon real happy.
He's pretty delirious right now. 76-23, baseline jumper doesn't go from Grant. Hargrove tries to kick it out and is chased down by Vicky Pardue. Lewis tried to give inside and Abraham fell down. Back come the Phantoms. Akeisha Fred just dribbled right past Grant, spots an open teammate. And contact, Chapman, no good. And Abraham ties up, but Chapman will be called for the personal. That'll be her second. It'll be a player control foul as Kigatan will not shoot as Phoebus has not gone over the limit yet. There you saw the blocked shot. Right here you see Grant. Well, I don't know. How do you call a foul on that? They both tied up on the ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure either.
Didn't look like she fouled her, but the official right on top of the play called it. Hargrove left open for a moment. Chapman, Hargrove. This is Keisha Reese, short from outside. And Grant rebounds for Kikutan. 5 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the ball game. 76-23. Stolen by Fret for Hargrove. Too far underneath. Back comes Lewis. Bad pass picked off by Chapman. Chapman is fouled by Pardue as she crossed the timeline.
Well, I'm not too sure about that foul. And I want to give Don Willis a little bit of static. He's way underneath the basket, and that happened way out here at half court. And I don't think that he was in the right angle to see that. that foul. As
here's
you can
some
see.
Of the replay.
But you reach around and see she reaches in, and that's what he sees her reaching in. And anytime you reach in, if you're a defensive ball player, you got to play defense with your feet first. You reach in with your hands, most of the time you're going to get that call.
And Chapman misses. Turnover will go back to the Phantoms. 76-23. Fret with the turnaround jumper. 34 points unofficially for Lakeisha Fret.
I tell you, it's going to be tough to go player of the game here and not her be sticking out like a sore thumb, but she did get it in her very first telecast, and I'm kind of leaning towards young Miss Reese. Keisha Reese, number 33, has really impressed me tonight as an all-around hustle out there, and I'm impressed with young T.J. Abraham over there with the Kickatan team. So those are the two that I'm leaning towards right now, and, of course, we've still got 4 minutes and 44 seconds to go.
This is Lewis into Abraham, and the foul on Fret. Three on Lakeisha Fret.
And that is not a shooting foul yet. And they're both going after the ball.
Fret blocked it out of bounds. Little more than 4 minutes to go. Fret misses, and Henry rebounds. Picked off underneath. Good defensive play by one of the subs in the game, Alkeisha Sneed. Baseline jumper, air ball, and a tie up underneath. Keisha Reese will come back in, and she'll replace Lakeisha Fret, who will come out of the ballgame with unofficially 33 points. She pretty much could score at will almost any time. Pretty scary when you're the opponent.
Yeah, it really is, but I tell you, I'm real impressed with Abraham. She did not back down, and she played her tough the whole ballgame. She ended up with four personals so far, but she has really worked hard trying to keep the ball away from her.
Pardue for three, won't go. And it goes over to the Phantoms. 3:12 remaining. 78-25. You see the Phoebus cheerleaders doing their thing here at the girls' game. And a double dribble. Christina Fields comes in, replacing Desiree Allen, who saw extensive action for the Phantoms. So it appears that right now, Kenya Vaughn and Reese are the only starters still in the ballgame.
You want me to?
We invite you to stay tuned. I think Bob's going to try and get a word with Mike Tallon over at the Phoebus bench at the conclusion of our ball game. And we are going to watch Reese shoot a little short. She gets the loose ball. Fouled, no call. Gives it to Snead underneath for the two.
Hey, the Phantoms do a great job, Tim, of going over after every loose ball on the floor.
60-25. So our players of the game will be Keisha Reese from Phoebus High School as Abraham scores, and she will be the player of the game for Kickatan. Abraham, well, I got to tell you, Fret's my player of the game, but we can give it to her every night that they play.
Reese, that's played, my feeling, yeah.
Reese played a fine ball game, 19 points, and she's played good defense all night, and she deserves the recognition.
You're going along with the two that I selected.
Yeah.
Great.
Pardue in and out. Abraham puts it back in. So it'll be Abraham and Reese, our players of the game. Unscientific, we hasten to add that. It's just our way of awarding a little recognition to these young ladies for a fine effort. Baseline bank shot is good. And that is by number 20 for Phoebus, Christina Fields. 82-29, a minute and a half to go. In for Abraham, off her fingers and out of bounds. More substitutions for the Phantoms. Verona Jenkins, number 32, comes in. Number 23 is in the ball game. I've got to check my listing for her. 23, you don't have her down there? Yes, you do. Crystal Johnson, okay. I want to make sure everyone gets recognized here. Put it up a little short. Pardue with the rebound. We didn't see Jamie Pardue at all this evening.
No, I thought we would see Jamie. Some we saw the other night when they played against Hampton, but not tonight.
Vicky Pardue throws up an air ball from three-point range. Less than a minute to play here in the ball game, 82-29. You've been watching Kickatan and Phoebus, the girls' game, the 29th of January, 1991. Tim Cole with Bob Hintz coming to you from Phoebus High School. Ball is still loose and finally controlled by Tashandra Henry. Now Lewis, half a minute to go. And then Lewis promptly throws it into the backcourt. Soon as Pardue touches it, it'll be a violation. So you're going to try to sneak down and get a word with Mr. Talon?
I'm going to sure do that, Tim. We got the 28 seconds, and I'm going to go down and talk to Mike, because I know the game's over. He's going to come over and shake hands with the players and the coach, and then I'll get him right there after. And hope Mr. Bateman will
Baton
will get us on camera.
From the corner, shot is no good. And then Grant took steps. So Keisha Reese came out a moment ago. Reese had 8 points at halftime. Added 11 in the second half to total 19 for the ball game. In and out, and then a foul as the 10 seconds show on the clock. Both teams over the limit, so 1-1 forthcoming. Kenya Vaughn finished the ball game tonight for Phoebus with 11 points. Abraham at the free throw line for the first time, stepping to the line. She had 16, that gives her 17. Added 11 points here in the second half. Henry with the rebound, can't get it to go, and then we got a tie up underneath. Six seconds remaining. Pardue from three-point range, short, and it'll still belong to Gigantan with 3 seconds to go. The Kickatan will fall to 5-7. Pardue again for three at the buzzer. It doesn't go. And the Phoebus Phantoms move to 12-0 and 15-0 overall. So the Kickatan Warriors, under first-year head coach Nita Cooper, get beaten for the second time this season by the Phantoms. And again, quickly, 8 points for Chapman. These are all unofficial. 33 for Frett, 19 for Reese, 11 for Vaughn, 2 for Sneed.
That's good, right there.
And 5 points for Janelle Hargrove. And right now, let's go down to the court. Bob has Mike Talon.
Thank you, Tim. Got Mike Talon here. Mike, you got to be pleased with the defense your team is playing.
Yeah, in spots, we did really well. That's the weakest our post defense has been all year long. But we kept good pressure on the perimeter, and I thought the kids overall played pretty well.
Well, this is the first time that you have played a team with two big people?
No. We played James Robinson. They had two girls, both 6'2", and both of them real strong. And we did a great job against them. Of course, we played zone. I just didn't want to play any zone tonight. I just want to see how we do man-to-man, which makes it tougher. If you get a one-on-one situation inside, 9 out of 10 times, the offensive player is going to win unless you've got great help on the ball.
Right, sure. I was really pleased with the way Janelle Hargrove, she is such a hustler out here, and Keisha Reese, all of them played great.
The effort that they gave was just outstanding. I thought Janelle really, I mean, she was on the floor all night. She's got to make a few layups once in a while for us, but, you know, her heart is there, and she really scrapped. And I thought Kenya Vaughn did a good job for us. She came around offensively. Frett, once she got rolling, just scored at will and made some great passes that were, you know, should have been converted to layups but weren't. So, you know, and I thought overall they did a great job.
Well, I did too. Congratulations.
Thanks,
on the win,
Bobby.
And we'll see you later on.
Hope so.
Okay, Tim, let's go back over to you.
All right, thank you, and our congratulations to Mike Talon as his team improves to 15-0, 12-0 in the district. And Anita Cooper, her team falls to 5-7. The final score again, the Phoebus Phantoms 82 and the Kickatan Warriors 30. For our crew and Bob Hintz, this is Tim Cole. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody. ¶¶